So every kid writes to one or two prompts. Then we take it from there, and the advanced theater students help me sort through, and we'll narrow it down, and I'll work them into that script.
Then we started getting. At first, I didn't care what people thought of it, because sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me. But sticks and stones and broken bones hurt me more than the verbal knives sent my way. I got picked on because of a lot of things: the way I dressed, the music I listened to, the way I did my hair. I got called emo and goth a lot. And you know the emo stereotype that society thinks of? Depressed and angry with slit wrists or whatever. A lot of people ask if I was depressed and or cut myself.
As you were reading that, I really think that would be a really good thing to use as a monologue or something.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. The only part is we'd have to cut out some of the things, like the slit wrists. Because I think that'd be,
Yeah, it's like a really touchy subject. And self-harm, I guess.
We want to touch. Not a lot on suicidal, but that was what it was about. A lot of it was talking about how she had to deal with that, being name-called and just all that stuff. But it's something that needs to be said and to be heard. So that's why I really liked it. And it was really stageable, so it was good.
A lot of people ask, are you depressed? Do you hurt yourself? They made me feel really bad about who I was. I didn't want to come off as some sad kid that's suicidal.
We are creating a whole culture in our learning community where the kids feel more free to talk about, hey, I've been bullied. My feelings have been hurt, and I'm going to talk to someone about it. And if an adult's not going to listen, then I'm going to talk to my friends until I feel better about it. And the friends share their own experiences with each other and build each other up.
My little sister, she's been getting bullied, and having this program and with me and all my friends who know how to deal with it, I feel safer about it and feel like I could help her more, because if I wasn't in this, I feel like I wouldn't be able to help her as much.
Coming here and watching and having these true stories, it really made me realize. And it made me look back and think, oh, was I doing that? Was I hurting somebody?
What am I doing?
This is not adults talking down to kids saying, this is what you do when you're bullied. Because honestly, kids don't listen. They're afraid of retaliation. They're afraid that it's not gonna work. For whatever fears they have, they don't trust. An adult that says, look, I was bullied. I know what you're going through. This is what you need to do. So this is kid to kid. This is kid saying, this is my experience. This is what I've been through. And this is what you can do to get through it.
We basically started with a meeting of about five of us and just started brainstorming some ideas on what this installation could be. And we, Jeremy Chatelaine actually mentioned that he thought it would be cool to do something really simple. Just with audio and visual and interactivity. First we had little balls where you're like moving them around and it was changing the pitch. And then we had things where you're shooting at objects and it was spinning them around and it was changing sounds. And Frank actually had a great idea about having something, some kind of metronome system happening where something would continually happen at the same time. And you'd move things into their path, and it would create some kind of rhythm.
As mentors at Spy Hop, we're constantly encouraging our students to collaborate on projects. So I think this is a good exercise in our staff collaborating and encouraging the public that walks in to collaborate on a piece of music together. At the very least, we want to see people, you know, leave here with smiles on their faces. So I think it's going to work.
And it wasn't until I started doing this more on a larger scale, expanding, that the goal and desire was to return to the farm, where I can have, you know, row upon row, plant upon plant, but I just don't have it. I have to use what's available to me, and that is using my friends and my neighbors' backyards. I'm connecting with my ancestors who were farmers. my great-grandparents, you know, they were so excited to move from the farm to the city, and I want to move back to where this all began for them. But my grandmother always says, why do you want to do that? It's hard work. You know, she's first generation off the farm back in Wisconsin. But I tell her that it's something that I love doing. And every year, as it's grown, I've, you know, made more money, and I'm still not to the point where I was when I left UPS, but I'm happier. You know, I have different stresses about bugs and heat and rain, I'm healthier. You know, mentally and physically, I'm healthier for doing it.
And inviting people to move in, to try and regulate who's going to move in by saying, you can't come here if you're Mexican, you can't come here if you're gay, you can't come here if you're Slavolian or whatever, I think is bigotry in its biggest sense, and I hate it.
I open the meeting up now to the City Council. Is there a motion to be made? Is there a motion to be made to rescind?
I'll make a motion that we rescind.
A motion has been made to rescind the resolution on the natural family. Do I hear a second? Please, less have civility and order in this. This is a legislative body action only. Do I hear I call for a second motion on the motion. The motion is to rescind the natural family resolution. Do I hear a second for this? This is the second call. If not, the motion is defeated. Thank you.
Everything that you have to control in there that used to be a knob, you do with a set of needle-nose pliers.
It's getting quite sad.
We utilize filmmaking and the digital arts as a tool of empowerment for young people.
One of my star students a few years ago refuses to ride in this van with me anymore because she said it gives her a migraine. I think mostly because the air conditioning doesn't work.
Whoa, there we go.
And sometimes the windows don't work.
I'm really short, and this seat isn't exactly adjustable. So I try to move it up as much as I can.